Right. Dynamic chatbot responses. Is it possible? So I had an interesting client interaction a few weeks ago that I wanted to share with you guys. So this particular individual came to me and said, Connor, I know that you normally build chatbots in voice flow, but I actually don't want you to build the particular chatbot that I want in voice flow. I want you to go to this other builder. And the reason that I am looking for this other builder is I want complete dynamic answers. And for those of you that have attempted to build out some of these chatbots, what we've been doing is we've been using the large language model to capture the intent. Okay, what does the user on the other end, what are they trying to do? Are they trying to gather information? Do they want to book a call? Do they want to see images of your previous work? You know, whatever the business functionality that you build out in these chatbots is what you're offering them. But what happens is once the large language model captures this intent, it's going to route the user into our particular flow path. Okay. But the problem with some of these flow paths is they're fixed, right? What is your name? What is your email? Like, what happens if the user on the other end ignores the chatbot questions or asks a completely different question that is not built in and ready to be handled by these particular linear flow paths? The chatbot breaks, right? Because it's anticipating that the user is going to listen and respond in a certain way. And trying to build out this dynamic functionality in these routes is cumbersome, right? You got to add all of these catch-alls and if statements, and let me use another AI step to look and see what the response is. If it's this response, go. And you end up, instead of these linear flow paths, you get these kind of complex webs where you have to try to anticipate every single response at every point in time in the chatbot. And like I said before, that's kind of a big lift, and it's difficult to do, and indefinitely is time consuming. And remember, these chatbot builders that we are using, one of the primary reasons that we're using them is we can build out AI assistants and chatbots quicker than hard coding them ourselves, and easier than hard coding them ourselves. So in order to get this dynamic functionality in these particular builders, it's kind of difficult. Now, one temporary workaround that I've seen people using and I have messed around with myself is it's the OpenAI Assistance API, right? Which gives you kind of like a ChatGPT-like experience with an OpenAI Assistance API. And that's because the thread memory on OpenAI Assistance API is actually pretty good and pretty strong. And what you'll see is people will spin up a replit server or host JavaScript code somewhere else, and then use VoiceFlow or BotPress kind of as the front-end UI wrapper around the back-end logic that sits in the OpenAI Assistance API plus replit server plus whatever people spin up. But for my low-code, no-code builders, this JavaScript, it's kind of intimidating, right? Because it's not something that you necessarily deal with. Where is my drag and drop elements that I can put on the designer? So, Connor, what is this particular builder that the client wanted, and how was the end result? What was the end result? Did you build anything? Was it cool? Was it useful? Did you learn something? And the answer is yes. Okay. And this particular builder is chatbotbuilder.ai, which kind of operates completely differently than what we are used to with some of these other builders. And one of the things that kind of jumps out to me is the channels and the integrations. There's a lot more. Let me just click this and connect it. This feels like a much more complete product than here's the framework, connect and develop out things yourself. But basically, what Chatbot Builder has done is I've kind of been able to hit this dynamic stuff, and I was so impressed by it that I embedded it on my website like almost immediately. So let me pull up a new version of my website here that I just pushed this past week, and let me show you some of this dynamic functionality. So if we scroll down here, I've replaced my FAQ section with a chatbot. I build chatbots. It makes sense for me to do that. So So it says, hi, welcome to Umbral. How can I help you today? Hi, what types of chatbots do you build? Got a variety of chatbots, customer service, sales, lead gen. Okay, that's a pretty great response. Great, I'd like to get started with a project. Fantastic, to get started, we need to book a discovery call. Please provide the following information, your full name, your email address, your preferred date and time. My availability is, and then I've got some, you know, days of the week and some times here. Let me know your preferred slot and I'll set it up for you. That's pretty nice. My name is Connor and my email address is connor@umbral.ai. Whoa, what the heck was that? Windows? Great, Connor. Could you please provide your preferred date and time for the discovery call based on the available slots? So it understood that I gave it my name and my email address, but it says, hey, you didn't pick a time. Whoops. My name is actually Billy. And I'll put two eyes there. Just not really a great response. No problem, Billy. Could you please provide your preferred date and time here with response? What are those types of chatbots that you've built again? Which is me testing these dynamic routes. Like, is it going to go completely off the rails here? We build various types of AI chatbots, which is the same answer that it came before. Let's see if I can get back on track. All right, let's continue. Preferred attainment time. Let's try Monday at 10 a.m. Looks like 10 a.m. slot on Monday is not available. Would you prefer 9:30 or 10:30? Okay. I got something on Monday at 10 o'clock, apparently, because I've integrated this with my Google Calendar. Your discovery call is scheduled for Monday at 10:30. You should receive an email shortly. Looking forward to speaking with you, Billy. If you have any other questions in the meantime, feel free to ask. Sure. Do you have any examples of bots you've built? Here's my YouTube channel. What are those booking details again? There we go. Monday at 10:30. Wait, what's the actual date of Monday? Monday, June 17th, 2024, which is good because I'm recording this on June 10th. So a week from now, next Monday. So this is kind of doing this dynamic functionality almost out of the box with very, very little prompting for me to do. And you can also notice, you see this little microphone here. I can talk and ask my questions. Gotta allow my microphone here. Hi, I was wondering, what is the pricing structure of Umbral? And there we go. I've got pricing structure here. So it was able to respond and understand my voice. If I hit play here, allow my microphone here. Hi, I was wondering, what is the pricing structure of Umbral? So now I have voice capabilities in this particular assistant as well, which I know voice callers are becoming more and more popular. And I'm starting to see a trickle down of requests, even on my end, to build out voice bots for particular clients. So I'd love, instead of, you know, jumping into Vappy or another platform that I have to learn, I'd like to just build out the backend logic in one platform. And then have the ability to either have it as a chatbot or voice caller. And it seems that Chatbot Builder is definitely trending in this direction, which is super powerful. And this is, if we look at the back end of Chatbot Builder here and some of these flows, I'm going to have a video where I go through this in more detail and even how I built out what's sitting on my website now. But we're getting the same kind of designer feel in these particular flows, but with function calling and the central brain, whatever they've got going on under the hood here, it's working. And whether they're using OpenAI Assistance APIs themselves, or they've have their own memory and state logic, it's pretty solid. So I think for my no-code and my low-code peeps that were looking for this dynamic chatbots, but still have a designer functionality where I can add, you know, messages with text and control the text and add images and carousel and video and stuff like that, this is a really, really strong solution. And even though I've been building primarily in voice flow, if you start to see more and more chatbot builder content on this channel, this is why. It's because I think I'm able to build out some pretty strong bots here out of the box, and they're connected to a lot of stuff. If we go through real quickly here into the settings, the channel, we got Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, Instagram, the SMS is Twilio. We've got all of this, Telegram. These are all very, very popular connections that if you were to go into the other platforms and try to hook up in, it's a little bit cumbersome. You might have to download a third-party app and pay another $15, $20 a month. But this is just here. It's in this platform already. And integrations. So that's my Google Calendar right there, which is why it said, hey, you've got something booked at 10 o'clock. It's because I've got something on my calendar already, and it's just a few clicks. So I know that this is a relatively quick video and I didn't really go over a ton, but I'm going to be making more content and building in Chatbot Builder going forward. And this is why. It's because I want that dynamic functionality. I want to be able to call functions that I can then see in a designer-like atmosphere where I can drag and click and, you know, have custom actions and call APIs and call information in, but still maintain the ability if the user on the other end goes off the rails. You can kind of start to handle all of these edge cases a lot cleaner inside of Chatbot Builder. So props to Chatbot Builder AI. And I've got a feeling this is probably going to be the first of many in this particular platform. Talk to you guys soon. Thanks.